Agent Starling?
Where the heck did this come from? It's practically mush.
It was found behind the soft palate of a murder victim. The body was in the Elk River in West Virginia.
It's Buffalo Bill, isn't it?
I'm afraid I can't tell you any more about that.
We heard about it on the radio.
You mean this is like a clue from a real murder case? Cool.
Just ignore him. He's not a PhD.
A sphingid ceratomia, maybe. Boy, he's a big sucker. Okay, let's check morphology. Agent Starling meets Mr. Acherontius Styx.
Weird.
Better known to his friends as the Death's Head Moth.
Now, where does it come from?
It's strange. Only live in Asia.
Asia?
In this country, they'd have to be specially raised from imported eggs.
Now, somebody grew this guy. Fed him honey and nightshade. Kept him warm. Somebody loved him.
Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today, as you guys can see, today is going to be another, I don't know if you guys can count this as special effects, but this is going to be another makeup tutorial that was actually inspired by Crispy. She's one of the makeup artists that I follow, and plus she's really beautiful, so why not? She actually does a lot of cool Halloween-ish, she does a bunch of makeup tutorials that I look up to, like the gangster clown, the skull that I actually did for Halloween last year, and now she did this butterfly one a while back. And I saw this, and she actually was inspired by another artist. I saw this, and I was really inspired, but I didn't want to do like a butterfly on my eye, because that ain't me. So I felt inspired by that video, and I thought, what if I add my twist to it? What if I bring the butterfly down to my mouth, switch the butterfly to a moth, and recreate the poster of Silence of the Lambs. Silence of the Lambs is one of my favorite movies of all time. Jodie Foster and Anthony Hopkins did an amazing job in the film, so I felt inspired to recreate this. Now, I'm not the best makeup artist around, so please bear with me with what I do today, and if you guys have any other methods that could actually improve this, go ahead, do with that what you will. But I actually tried to do this to the best of my abilities. I'm not the best makeup artist out there. I'm not pro or anything. I'm an amateur, so I worked with what I got. All I got is the flash palette and eyeshadows. I'm not perfect and nobody is. So without further ado, let's get into the video.
It rubs the lotion on its skin. It does this whenever it's told.
Starting off, I shaved. I'm taking some Wet n Wild primer and priming my face. I didn't know I had to, but apparently it's important. Next, I'm taking the lightest lip liner I can find and sketching out the shape of the moth. It's a good idea to have a reference picture nearby to help you out. The wings have to match shape and size, otherwise it'll look off and lopsided, and nobody wants that. Once you're satisfied with the sketch, fill it in. I'm using this brown from my flash palette. Next, fill in the bottom wing with some yellow. These both are going to act as bases for the rest of the look. On the reference photo, the body of the moth is a shade of orange. I tried multiple times to achieve that color and I couldn't figure it out, so we're just gonna use yellow. Now we're gonna grab some white and set the base for the skull's head. When doing this, think of Padme from Star Wars. Well, her bottom lip. Here's a mistake I did. I'm barely setting in the creams right now. Every time you apply cream paint, set it in with the matching eyeshadow after you're done. Luckily, the colors didn't mix. Here, I am setting in the yellow with some yellow eyeshadow. And now I'm doing the same step again, but with the brown. And now with the white. I guess these steps were pretty self-explanatory. Next, with NYX's Jet Black Eyeliner, I'm basically drawing a border between the colors so they don't mix. I'm so dumb. I totally forgot to paint in the moth's head, antennas, hands, and legs. With my black eyeshadow, I'm shading in the moth's body. I know it looks like a bee, I get it, but I'm gonna fix it. The best method in doing this is shading in Z shapes. With the brown shade, I'm gonna add some shape and texture on the bottom half of the wing. The way I found works best is to flick the brush down. And so the yellow and the brown don't mix, I'm gonna add some brown on my bottom lip. With that same brown, I'm cleaning up the edges on the top wing. Again, I am so dumb. I pointed at the blue, but with the black, I'm sharpening up the edges of the whole moth. Using that same method that we used before, with the yellow, we're gonna shade in and then flick it, not down, but upwards. With some white, I'm gonna attempt to highlight the yellow, but I failed. Going back to the flash palette, I'm gonna use some yellow and add some more to add some texture and color on the wings. To finish it all up, we're gonna grab some black and paint on the skull's head. It's not my best skull, I promise, I could do better, but at the moment I was thinking about Grimm from The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy. Oops, I lied. Lastly, I'm gonna go back to the NYX eyeliner again to add some texture on the wings. I know I should have used a liquid eyeliner, but I had a movie to catch that day. And now, I'm done.
I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you guys did, please give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe, and leave a comment down below. And I'll see you guys next Friday. See you later, alligators.
Dr. Lecter.